Hi students, hope all are safe and fine by the grace of God. I am happy to teach this session for you. Let's start. Categories of computers and computer languages, part 2. In the last class, we saw about what is generation of computers, the first and the second generation of computers. In the first generation, the technology used was vacuum tubes. In the second generation, the technology used was transistors. Hope you all remember the last class. In today's class, we'll see about the third generation, fourth and the fifth generation of computers. The third generation was between the year 1964 to 1970. The characteristics of third generation computers are, they used integrated circuits in place of transistors. In short, they are called as IC. An IC is also called as a chip, and it may contain thousands of transistors. Integrated circuit has a lot of transistors inside it, and it is called as a chip. As a whole, it is called as a chip. They use keyboard for input and monitor for output. Like how we use today, in those days also in the third generation, they used keyboards for input and monitor for output. But today we have lot of input and output devices. But in the third generation, they used only keyboard and monitor as input and output devices. They were smaller, faster, cheaper, and more efficient than early computers. Hence, they were made available for general public. In the third generation, every people started using computers because it was smaller, faster, as well as cheaper, and more efficient than early computers. In the first and the second generation, the computers were large, they were not very fast, they were costly. But so people were not able to use it. In the third generation, the computer's size was smaller, the computer was faster than the previous generations, and the cost was effective because everybody were able to afford and buy a computer in the third generation. For example, IBM 360, Apple I, ICL 1900 were examples of third generation computers. I have shown the picture of third generation computers here. The first one, the bigger picture, is the IBM 360, and the second picture is Apple I, and the other one here I've shown is a smaller version of the Apple computer. Hope you all understand. Hope it is visible. Take a look of all the three. If you want, if you are using a phone, you can take a screenshot of this. Next, we will see about the fourth generation computers. The fourth generation started from 1971 till present. Till now, we are using the fourth generation computers. The characteristics of the fourth generation computers are, they use microprocessor. So, what is a microprocessor? A microprocessor is a very large scale integrated circuit that contains many ICs in a single chip. First, we saw what is IC. IC has a lot of transistors into one chip. But here, we are using lot of ICs in a single chip, and it is called as microprocessor. If we have lot of transistors in a single chip, it is called as integrated circuit. If we have lot of integrated circuits in a single chip, it is called as microprocessor. They are more reliable and powerful than computers of the previous generation. The microprocessor is a faster, it is very fast than ICs because we have lots of ICs in a single chip. and we can rely on it anytime. And they are also powerful than the previous generations. They are more faster, they are more effective and more efficient for all sorts of work. They use keyboard, mouse, scanner and so on for input, and monitor, printer and speaker as output devices. As I told you, in the previous generation, third generation, they used keyboard and as input and monitor as output. But nowadays we use keyboards, mouse, scanner as input and monitors, printers and speakers as output devices. If you have any other input and output devices, you can recollect it, and you can also share it in the chat box. One input device which I come across nowadays, it is used, is a mic. The mic is an input device. They have higher storage capacity. The memory of the fourth generation computers is very large, and we can obviously store lot of data, lot of information in fourth generation computers. The storage capacity is very large. They are smaller, cheaper and faster than the previous generation computers. Yes, as I told you, the third generation was cheaper than the previous generation. The fourth generation is much smaller, much cheaper and more faster than the previous generation computers. Example is the Apple Macintosh, HP 9000 and IBM PC. I have shown the pictures in the next slide. Yeah, this is the microprocessor, which consists of lot of integrated circuits inside it. And this is this, the next picture is the size of the microprocessor. It is very small. You can take a screenshot if necessary. If you are using a laptop, you can just press print screen and save the picture. Okay, we'll go to the next slide. This is the Apple Macintosh computer. You would have seen these kind of computers, because these are the computers we are using now. The next computer you would have seen in your schools, in your laboratory, you might be using such kind of computers. These are the fourth generation computers. Then go to the next slide. Yes, now it is the fifth generation computers, present and beyond. The fifth generation computers we are using now as well, but the future computers, what will be the aim of the future computers is what we are going to see in the fifth generation computers. What we are using now about in the fifth generation computers are artificial intelligence like voice recognition, face recognition in your phones. You would have seen your fingerprint recognition and your face recognition. So that is what we are using in the fifth generation computers. They use ultra large scale integrated chips. This is microprocessor having 10 million components inside a single chip is called as ultra large scale integrated chips. So that is the technology used in the fifth generation. You might not understand as soon as I tell you. You can tabulate each generation, and if you tabulate and study, it will be very easy and very helpful for you, and you will also understand better. So what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is is making a system think like a human. How we think, we laugh, we smile, we cry, all these are what humans do. Making a system feel what humans think is called as artificial intelligence. That is what the computer engineers are trying nowadays, to make a system think like a human and perform tasks like human. What do humans do? What kind of tasks do? Humans talk, humans react, humans make decisions. They also show expressions and face that they are making systems do all these things. Artificial intelligence is making a system think like humans and perform tasks like humans, such as voice recognition, decision making, and translation between languages. You would have seen an advertisement where a phone translates language. A person will go to China or some other country, and he knows only English. The opposite person who is talking with him doesn't know English. So he, as soon as the China person talks, he asks the computer what he is talking, and the computer translates the voice. So that is artificial intelligence in translation between languages. They have the ability to solve complex problems, including decision making and logical reasoning. This artificial intelligence systems have a power called decision making, which is so far it was done only by humans, but today the systems have a problem solving kind of decision making and also logical reasoning. This is the artificial intelligence used now. The first picture is a picture of a robot, and her name is Sophia. I think you all would have seen videos about Sophia. If not, you can just Google, or you can do a YouTube. You can see a YouTube video about Sophia talking. She laughs, she cries, she does everything like a human. And the next is the face recognition, which we use in phones. And the next picture is a voice recognition, like translation of language is also done through voice recognition. You should definitely watch a video about Sophia talking. Sophia's the way she talks and smiles, it will be very interesting. So ask your parents about this, and you can watch her video.